Hello everyone. As you may have already seen from my previous videos on this accessory device, the Fluke i400E has a rated duty cycle of 1 ampere to 400 amperes. I didn't think it was capable of measuring below 1 ampere since the user's manual did not mention anything about it. However, one of you guys apparently used the i400E with a UNI-T 61D plus multimeter and managed to get a 0.220 millivolt reading, which translated to 220 milliamperes. This value is below the stated duty cycle of 1 ampere. I will conduct a little experiment of my own to see for myself. Please note that the outcome of this test is not a supplement to the officially published specifications of the i400E. Take this video only for its informative or educational value. Since the purpose of this experiment is to test for milliampere current, I'll keep this simple and use my 40 watt Black & Decker box fan, running it through its different fan speeds. This should be a good representative of small household loads. For the first test, I'm going to use the Fluke 116 at its millivolt setting to get the value of the fan current, if any, and compare that to the value that would be detected by the Fluke 324. The Fluke 324 clamp meter is reading 110 milliamperes, while the Fluke 116 connected to the i400E reads zero. Next, I will use the UNI-T 161T multimeter at its millivolt setting, AC millivolt setting. The clamp meter registers a reading of 100 milliamperes, while the 191T reads zero. For this last test, this is the UNI-T 139C digital true RMS multimeter. As you can see, the terminal ports here are diagonal in arrangement, but they are still perfectly matched and compatible with the cable of the Fluke i400E. Let's compare the values with the Fluke 324 by setting this to millivolt AC. It looks like I have something here. The clamp meter Fluke 324 reads 0.13 ampere, and that is 130 milliamperes, while the UT139C reads a value of 0.13 millivolt, which also translates to 140 milliamperes. So far, this looks like a perfectly or almost identical milliampere readings. I'm going to switch now to fan speed number 2. There is also an increase in the value of the millivolt reading and the milliampere reading with the two devices. Now for fan speed number 3. I'm getting a reading of 160 milliamperes at the UT139C and 150 milliamperes at the Fluke 324. So for this experiment, between fan speed 1, 2 and 3, the two devices were giving nearly identical milliampere readings. Let's take a look at the millivolt range of the Fluke 116 and the UT191T. It appears that you have identical millivolt resolution. There is just one digit after the decimal point. it should be the hundredth of a millivolt in this place here. On the other hand, the UT139C has a higher resolution, two digits after the decimal point. This is the place for a tenth of a millivolt, and this is also similar to the resolution of the Fluke 324. According to the specifications of the UT139C, the resolution for AC millivolt is 0.01, so that's practically 10 microvolt. So in theory, it can detect that tiny amount of voltage. This flexibility of the Fluke i400E to work with a digital multimeter having high resolution AC millivolt function appears to extend its usefulness a little bit more. Just be mindful that the manufacturer provided accuracy ratings within the 1 ampere to 400 ampere range only, not below 1 ampere. You may have to use another check meter to verify results in your own work setting. Thank you for watching. Stay safe.